Right. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim tasliman kathira. We always begin with the praise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send our prayers of peace upon our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin fil awaleen wa salli wa sallim wa barik ala Muhammadin fil akhireen. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa zid wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin fil mala'il a'la ya arhamar rahimeen. It is always an honor and a privilege to ever gather for the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And alhamdulillah, the number of countries, continents, mashallah, that are represented here. Those of you who have come from Europe, from Asia, myself from Australia, those who have come from North America, mashallah, our brothers and sisters from South Africa. We have covered just about every part of the world except the Arctic. And the Antarctic. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes the time that we spend together a time and a testament for us, one of blessing upon ourselves, our homes, and our families. Allahumma ameen. I want you to consider this the second kind of formal discussion about the life of Imam al-Bukhari. And today, inshallah, we want to speak a little bit about mustalah al-hadith, the classifications or the nomenclature of hadith. And I said that the purpose of this is not to speak of it in an academic sense, but to speak of it as a shirk proof. That I want, inshallah, that the information that you receive is something that solidifies your heart upon the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in knowing the sources of our aqidah. The aim is to allow you to understand that the wahy that was given to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is something that has been protected by Allah. Our dear elder Mawlana Ibrahim Bam yesterday, he spoke about the first hadith and that the first chapter of Sahih al-Bukhari is about the beginning of revelation. And I wanted to add takmila, just a small increase to the benefit inshaAllah, to add greater benefit. Al-Imam al-Bukhari chooses this particular chapter, which is something that is a uniqueness in his arrangement of the hadith. Because unless you understand that this is a wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then everything that's going to come after it is for naught. Unless you understand that what you're about to hear as narrations from the Prophet ﷺ is not from himself, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ in Surah Al-Najm, he does not speak of his own volition, of his own opinion, إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ. It is a revelation revealed upon him ﷺ. To clarify this, because in some narrations and in some seerah, you will see that the Prophet would change his mind. On the Battle of Badr, the Prophet ﷺ, as is reported in the Sahih, he had camped in one side, and the Sahaba, they asked, when he asked them for advice, what do you think of this? They said, perhaps, O Messenger of Allah, if we were on the other side of the valley and we cut off the water supply of the people of Quraysh coming out of the desert, it would be more strategic. He took his counsel to Allah and agreed. The question was this instructed to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, no, I saw this as a strategic place. They said, well, over there, it may hold more strategic value, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are instances in the life of the Prophet ﷺ that are of his own description, his own desire, his own wording, that are not revelation, that are not tantamount to acts of worship and faith. When we speak about the wahy, we speak of it in terms of faith. The word wahy is a very interesting word as well. The word wahy is used in the Quran in a variety of different contexts. The first context of the word wahy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is what you and I commonly understand. Revelation, meaning ilham, it is an inspiration from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to one of His chosen. And Allah says in Surah Ash-Shura subhanahu wa ta'ala that the wahy will come, that Allah will speak to an individual directly. Musa alayhi salam, Kalimullah, is the one conversant with Allah. Or through the means of an angel. And the word malak, it comes from two Arabic words, aluka, meaning a messenger, wa mullika, someone who's been given strength. So they've been given strength to deliver a message. So they are called al-mala'ika, right? The third means of wahy to a prophet or a messenger of Allah is that it comes min wara'i hijab, that Allah will converse with them from beyond a barrier. وَحِجَابُهُ النُّورِ in the hadith of Imam Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ says, the hijab of Allah Azza wa Jal is his light. لَوْ كَشَفَهُ لَأَحْرَقَتْ سُبُحَاتُ وَجْهِهِ. If he was to unveil, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessing of His Majesty would bring to destruction all that the Basar was to encounter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to gaze upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be blessed with the sight of our Creator on the Day of Judgment and in Jannatul Firdaus. Allahumma ameen. Wahy also takes the context in our Sharia and in the studies of our deen as being al-ilhamu bi-khafa, that someone is given information that others are not aware of. So just say, I'm thirsty, and I hold up my empty cup and I shake it at Dr. Musaji, he knows I'm thirsty, right? Something that is a communication between others without speaking. And this form of communication, Allah gives examples of it in the Quran. وَأَوْحَى رَبُّكَ إِلَى النَّحْلِ. Allah put an instinctive desire within bees. أَنِ اتَّخِذِي مِنَ الْجِبَالِ بُيُوتًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also refers to wahy as being from the shaytan upon those who are allies to the shaytan. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِيَائِهِمْ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ. That the shayateen will inspire within the chest of man and upon their tongue words of deception to lead you astray. There's also the wahy that comes in the form of a dream. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He would give information to Ibrahim alayhi salam and many of the other prophets of Allah. And the Prophet alayhi salam says in the authentic hadith that nothing remains behind in the ummah. It is one of 46 parts of prophethood that remains in our ummah after his departure alayhi salam, ar-ru'ya, that you see a vision that is righteous, that is sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a form of revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal. So the concept of wahy is very important. Imam al-Bukhari begins with the chapter of wahy, that you come to know that revelation is protected by Allah Azza wa Jal. And therefore he begins then the first hadith with innama al-a'malu bin-niyat. This hadith, wallahi, if we were to sit with our ulama, they would sit and discuss it with us for month after month. And it would be word by word. What does innama mean? I remember Shaykhna Muhammad Awama, innama, this word. In English, you would translate it as surely actions are. But innama is selective. Is it all actions or is it some actions? Is it religious actions? Is it actions that are voluntary? Is it actions that are ordered upon you? And it's a very important process to have this humility with the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, that we understand every time it is approached, every time it is studied, that there is something greater that is attained than what was initially there. Al-a'malu bin-niyat. One can say all actions are tantamount to their niyyah. You know these people who have no faith in Allah in the way that we believe. They will write books. One book is called The Secret. They'll make episodes and about, you know, you can, if you really want something, if you commit your heart and you make your intention to attain something, you will attain it. And this is literally what the Prophet ﷺ is saying. Everything you really want, that you put in your heart and make as a mission in your life, you will eventually attain it. And the Prophet ﷺ says, the one who's going to make hijrah, the one who's going to make business, the one who's going to, they will achieve what it is they set upon achieving. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes our niyyah towards Him, when we make our heart firm that we want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala equally, you will attain that niyyah with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is past all of the beautiful things that were shared by our dear Imam Mawlana Ibrahim Bab. Let's speak a little bit about Al-Imam Al-Bukhari.